Relative humidity is a critical value when you're trying to understand potential fire behavior. What is relative humidity, and why does it make such a difference in our fuel moistures and then our fire behavior? Let's look at a quick demonstration to see what relative humidity is and how that affects our fuels. This is a parcel of air in our example. This parcel of air is what the parcel of air might look like, let's say at 12 o'clock noon. This parcel of air is completely saturated. It has a certain number of air molecules that are going to change as the temperature of the air changes. So let's say as we move on throughout our day and our air increases, now it's 1300, 1400, and we have an increase in the temperature of our air and a decrease in our relative humidity. But if you'll notice, the amount of water didn't change, but the ability for the air to hold water changed. As the air increased in temperature, its size expanded because the air molecules are taking up more space. And there's more of a capacity for this air to hold moisture. So 1500, 1600, we have more of an increase in our temperature of our air. And again, our relative humidity is decreased, our temperature has increased, but the amount of water that's in the air has not changed. This air could hold another 2 times the amount of moisture without hitting that point of saturation. So let's go back in time, becomes evening, now it's 2200, and we see a decrease in our temperature, our relative humidity starts to go up. Now it's midnight, temperatures go down more, relative humidities go up more, and we again reach that point of saturation. And in the morning, we see that we have decreases in temperature again, and we have now hit the point of complete saturation, and we have precipitation or dew. This is the point at which we reach our dew point, where the air has no more capacity to hold the amount of moisture, and it removes that amount of moisture through precipitation or dew. So how does this affect our wildland fuels and our fire behavior? Let's take a look. This jar represents an air parcel that has 90% relative humidity. This jar represents an air parcel that has 10% relative humidity. This jar can only hold 10% more moisture. This jar can hold 90% more moisture. Let's say that we are in a parcel of air that has 90% relative humidity, like in that first jar. This stick would gain moisture from that parcel of air because this stick has less moisture in it than the air does, and so moisture is going to move from that air into the fuel particle and it's going to become more wet. For the second jar with 10% relative humidity, if that becomes our air mass, this fuel particle has more moisture than that 10% relative humidity, and that air is going to pull moisture from the stick, drying the stick out. Now, let's say we have a leaf. This leaf has a much higher surface area to volume ratio. There's more area around it, and so the likelihood of that drying and wetting, it's just gonna happen faster in fuel particles with higher surface area to volume ratio. So things like grass and needles and small sticks and leaves, these things are going to be more fluctuating based on what is happening in the air around it. Larger fuel particles, like larger sticks and stumps, those things are going to gain and lose moisture a lot slower. Let's get back to our jars to see how relative humidity can impact fire behavior. When we have 10% relative humidity, we'll have fuels that are drier. When we have 90% relative humidity, we'll have fuels that are wetter. Well, why does moisture in fuel make a difference for fire behavior? In order for something to ignite, it needs to reach a certain temperature of ignition. When fuels are wet, it takes longer to reach that temperature. Just think about when you get out of a pool and how cold you feel. Well, you feel cold because it takes energy to evaporate water, and that energy decreases your temperature. The same thing's happening with the fuels. The more water that's in a fuel particle, the more it needs to be evaporated to dry out, and the cooler that fuel particle becomes, which means it takes longer for that to reach a temperature where it's going to light, maybe it won't even get there at all. So fuel particles that are wet, they are not going to burn or not going to burn very much. And fuel particles that are dry are going to be more likely to ignite and perhaps burn with higher intensity. What's this all mean? Means that relative humidity has an impact on fuel moisture. And fuel moisture has an impact on fire behavior.